Hey everybody, it's Jang here at the far end of my Lego city, and in this video I'm just going to talk about Jurassic World stuff. My wife and I have now seen the Jurassic World movie itself. If you have not seen it, I do recommend it. It's an entertaining movie. But if you've not seen it, I do recommend that you stop this video and don't watch it, because there will be some mild spoilers. No major plot spoilers or anything, but some things will be revealed here, because I'm going to reference the movie and compare and contrast to what we actually got in the Lego Jurassic World sets, which were released long before the movie came out. The most important set to talk about, of course, is the Indominus Rex breakout set, which includes the I-Rex itself, as well as this large enclosure here. And because of my limited space here, I had to split the setup into two parts, so the other part of it is over there, the Overwatch little tower area. Now that section right there, especially the upper floor of it, the railing and such, I think looks really good, very accurate to what's in the movie. I really felt like I was looking at the real world version of the Lego set when I saw that scene show up the first time. The main enclosure itself is fine. I think that it captures everything that you wanted to be able to see that was in the movie. The crane is completely wrong, but I think it's an okay little substitution that they did there. The crane in the movie is nothing like that. It's just a cable-based system, but this definitely adds a lot more play value to it, and the color scheme, I think, works out pretty well. So that is completely forgivable, if you ask me. The door setup, I think, is fine. It has a little bit of a tribute, I'd say, to the Jurassic Park movies and the entranceway and such, but they kind of tied it into the way that they did in the movie, and they allow you to recreate the scene from the movie itself. However, they do give you an extra way to get the I-Rex out by breaking down that wall over there, which is not something that we saw in the movie at all, but it's just extra play value. So again, I think it's actually a good thing. Now the I-Rex itself, I don't know. I really like this I-Rex that Lego did. However, it's not very accurate to what we saw in the movie. I think it needed a much smaller head to really differentiate it from the regular T-Rex, and just to get its looks a little bit better. I also think that the base color could have been very light gray. Not light gray, but very light gray. It's a rarer color that Lego has in their current color palette. Just would have worked out better. Moving on, how about the Dilophosaurus ambush set, which includes that Jeep right there, which does not show up in the movie. Well, it's basically trying to be an original Jurassic Park Jeep, which does show up in the movie, but this is a Jurassic World version, and I just don't get it. I don't see why they went with that scheme. They could have gone with one of the other more noticeable vehicles in the movie. And then the Dilophosaurus itself, which is currently checking out the garbage bin over at Quickie Mart here, it doesn't show up in the movie, not in physical form. There's a hologram of it in a very, very brief scene, but that's just it. Moving along, T-Rex Tracker. Okay, let's talk about that T-Rex Tracker set. Or is it Trapper? Tracker? Tracker. That's not in the movie. Not in any way, shape, or form. I think I mentioned that in my original review, having not even seen the movie, but It did not seem like something that was going to show up in the movie, and indeed it did not. Not in any way, shape, or form. I don't see why they needed to make this set. They've done basically the same thing previously in the Dino theme that Lego has done. It's something, I guess, that sold well, but doesn't really go with the movie. The T-Rex does go with the movie, but that whole set, nah. Moving on, Pteranodon Capture, which includes this helicopter right here, and that Pteranodon. Well, lots of Pteranodons and that exact helicopter do appear in the movie in the same scene. Is it in this same context? No, but I think that it's perfectly fine to keep them together, and I think that it was good to include this helicopter from the movie. It's recognizable. I think they did a respectable job of recreating it, and it's good to get a Pteranodon. Would have been nice to get more of them, actually. How about Raptor Rampage, which includes the big Unimog, the Unimog Mercedes, big old mobile vet unit, which also includes two of the Raptors, velociraptors. I've got my velociraptors kind of spread about this display, but that makes total sense to have velociraptors that can be chasing after the Unimog. They definitely go together in the movie. I still think that this is a pretty good representation of the Unimog design that's used in the movie. Just needs to be lowered to the ground. It's definitely up too far off the ground. There's also inside of there a deployable turret, which isn't in the movie, but that's fine. That's just extra play value. I think that everything that was important there was captured pretty well. We've also got a raptor escape set, which includes two raptors and a pen for them. That's fine. Small set, gets the general idea across. They've got the little walkway up above. In the movie, that was a much larger thing for sure. But to get it into a small set with a couple of raptors and with a pen, I think it was a difficult thing to do for the designers to get it within budget, but I think it makes sense. I think that actually turned out pretty well. I think that it's a good set to have in the line. It has a pretty respectable price to it, and it's accurate enough. It's believable enough. I think that kids can identify with that after having seen the movie. Also spread across a few of the sets are two gyrospheres, which we already knew are supposed to have two seats in them each, and they just weren't able to fit that within a reasonable size to still be able to accommodate the minifigure. So choosing to do that with a single minifigure design, I think, was a good compromise. I think if they made it actually hold two minifigures, it would have been just too huge. And this, I think, was well done. There's also an ATV in there, a little quad, and that's just fine. Those were used in the movie as well. All told, I think that it's about a 60% hit, a 60% good shot with the stuff that they've done here. The IREX pen, I think, is good. The Velociraptor pen, I think, is good. The Unimog, I think, is good. The gyrospheres, those are good. Helicopter is good. Inclusion of Pteranodon, good. Dilophosaurus itself, doesn't make sense. Jeep doesn't make sense. That should not have been made. They should have put the T-Rex in with something else. Let me know what you think. Hopefully you have seen the movie since you've seen this video now. I really don't want to spoil it for anybody. Let me know what you think about the differences between what showed up in the movie and what we actually got for sets. And, you know, let me know what you think about some of the compromises that LEGO has had to make and some that they made probably intentionally to increase the play value, maybe at a little bit of the expense of accuracy and authenticity to the movie. I'm definitely interested in hearing what different folks of different age ranges think about those trade-offs. I think that overall, still a really good theme. The stuff looks good, but given that a lot of this stuff was really designed from scratch, and in the case of the IREX, they were actually able to make brand new molds for it, I just feel like they could have done better if they had access to good materials in the beginning when it was time to design these, which we don't even know. We don't even know if they knew what these things were actually going to look like. So again, thank you for your feedback in advance. I'll be talking to you again soon.